हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, ट्री अ नॉन लीनियर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। फ्रॉम द ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द बाइनरी सर्च ट्री। The binary search tree and its introduction and characteristics, now I am going to explain you. So the binary search tree is having a special behavior or a special characteristic. That is nothing but every left child must have a value which is less than its parent node value, and every right child must have a value which is greater than its parent node value. For example, I have shown the binary search tree over here. Here you can see that if we'll consider the node 14, for this its left child is having value less than its parent node and the right child is having value greater than a parent node. Let's consider 27 root node as a parent node, and here you can see all the nodes which are present in a left subtree are having values which are less than the value of root node, that is a parent node 27, and all the nodes which are present in a right subtree of a parent node, they are having values which are greater than the value of a parent node. So this is nothing the concept behind the binary search tree. Now let's see which operation we can perform on a binary search tree with their significance. The first one is to create a binary search tree. That you can do by inserting a root node in a binary search tree. Then let's see the next operation that can be performed on a binary search tree is nothing but the insertion of an element or a node into a binary search tree. We also can perform the search operation to search any particular element from a binary search tree. We can perform a delete operation to perform or to delete any particular element from the binary search tree, and if I want to display the tree, that also I can do with the help of display function or the traversal operation of the binary search tree. Now let's start with the first operation, that is creation of a binary search tree. So if I want to start for the creation of a binary search tree, so what is the create operation? This operation will help you to create a binary search tree. Whenever you are going to insert a very first node, that is nothing but the creation of the tree, and that node will be treated as a root node of a binary search tree. So let's start for the create operation. So for the creation of the operation, so for the creation of the binary search tree, we have to accept the first node as a root node, and here you can see that this is a root node, is not having currently not any left child and a right child, so that's why we can say that we have created a binary search tree. Now after this, what we have to do, we have to perform the next operation is nothing but the insert operation. While performing the insert operation, what we have to do, we have to take care of the node which is already created by us and which we are going to treat as a root node. After that, for the insertion operation, for the insertion of any of the element in your binary search tree, you have to locate a proper location of every new node which we want to insert into the binary search tree. For this, we have to follow these steps. The first step is we have to start from a root node. Then as far as the property or a characteristic of binary search tree was concerned, we have to check for any particular or a proper position by comparing a root node with the key which we are going to insert. After that, we have to take a decision. If key is less than a root node, then we will go for a left subtree, because this is only the property of your binary search tree. All the elements present in a left subtree of a root node are less than root, and all the nodes which are present in a right subtree are greater than, they are having a value which is greater than a value of root node. So if your key is less than the root node, go to the left subtree and find out a proper position. But if your key is greater than the root node, that is else part, you have to move to the right subtree and you have to find out a proper position in a right subtree. These steps you have to perform repeatedly to find out a proper location for every insertion key. So let's start to solve the example. As we have created a root node while creation of the binary search tree, let's consider about this root node and let's think about this is the key which I want to insert into the binary search tree. Now let's compare the insertion key with the root node. As you can see, key is less than the root node. You have to find out a proper position in the left subtree and then you have to insert a node. Now here you can see that this 56 is a root node but is not currently having any left child. So as the left child is not present, attach the node 25 as its left child itself and move forward for the insertion of a next node into your binary search tree. Here you can see that if I want to insert a new node and its key value is 65, what is my first step? My first step is to compare the insertion key with the root node, and here you can see that as 65 is greater than the value of a root node, then you have to find out a proper position in a right subtree and then you have to insert a node. But here you can see that no right child is present, so that's why insert or attach the key value as its right child. And here you can see that your tree is growing and by following the characteristic or the property of a binary search tree. Now let's insert a new node, which is 36. First of all, you have to start the comparison from the root node only. Compare your insert key with the root node and you can see that as the key value is 36 and it is compared with 56, as key value 36 is less than the root node value 56, that's why we have to find out a proper position into a left subtree. That's why now compare the left child, that is 25, as it is present, compare the value 25 with the key node and after that let's find out a proper position. Here you can see that 36 is greater than 25, so that's why the insertion will be as the right child of a parent node 25, and in this way the node 36 is inserted into the binary search tree. Let's insert a new node, that is 86. Let's start with the comparison of a key value with the root node. As the key value is greater than the root node, that's why I find out a proper position in a right subtree. As right child is present, compare 86 key value with the right child of root node 56, which is 65. Again you can see that 86 is greater than 65, so that's why you have to attach 86 as a right child of 65, as 65 is not currently having any right child. So that's why insert it, and after insertion your tree will look like this. Let's insert a new node, 72. Let's compare it with a root node. As 72 is greater than 56, move to the right sublist, move to the right subtree. 65, compare 72 with 65. As 72 is greater than 65, move to its right child, compare it with 86. Again, 72 is less than 86 and let's check whether the left child is present to 86 or not. It's not present, so that's why attach 72 as a left child of a root node 86, or we can say a parent node 86. Now let's compare a new key value with the root node 56. As 19 is less than 56, check for its left child. As it is present, step down to a left child and make it as a root node. 19, compare with 25. As no left child is present to 25, because 19 is less than 25, attach 19 as a left child of a parent node 25. So in this way, we can perform the insertion operation onto the binary search tree. Again, for a practice, let's insert a new node. It is compared with root node 56. As 8 is less than 56, let's move to the left child 25 as it is present. Let's compare it with 25. As again 8 is less than 25, step down to the left child of 25 to check the proper position where we can insert a key value 8. Let's compare it with 19. After comparison it with 19, you have to decide whether to insert it into the left child or into a right child. So here you can see that 8 is less than 19, so let's attach 8 as a left child of a 19 as a parent node. So in this way your tree will look like this. Now let's insert one more value, 22, compare it with 56, less than 56, that's why compare it with 25, less than 25, compare it with 19, greater than 19, and no right child is present, attach it as a right child. So in this way we can perform the insertion operation onto the binary search tree. Now let's solve the example, another example. Now let's start with the creation of binary search tree. Let's insert another value 86, as it is greater than 52, attach it as a right child because no right child was present for 52. For a next value 65, it is less than 86 but greater than 55, that's why it will belong to the right subtree of 52 but less than 86, that's why a left child of 86. 79, where it will go? It will go to the right subtree of 52, it will compare with 86. After that it will decide, we will decide that 79 is less than 86, so that's why move to 65. After moving to 65, as it is greater than 65, attach it as a right child. Next node is 24, attach it as a left child of a root node 52. 18, again after comparison with 52, 24, it will move to 18 as a, it will attach as a left child of a 24. Then 21, right child of 18. 12, a left child of 18. Then 7, again starting from the comparison with a root node 52, it is less than 52, it will compare with 24, less than 24, compared with 18, less than 18, compared with 12, less than 12, but no left child is present, so that's why attach it as a left child of root node 12 or a parent node 12. 15, less than 52, less than 24, less than 18, but greater than 12. So let's check whether 12 is having a right child. No right child, so that's why attach it as a right child. 91, starting comparison with a parent node or a root node actually. 91 is greater than 52, greater than 86, no right child is present, so that's why attach it as a right child. Next node is 94, again start with a root node, greater than 52, move to the right child. Greater than 86, move to the right child. Greater than 91, move to the right child. No right child is present, so that's why attach itself as a right child. Next node is 75. Let's start comparing with the parent node or a root node. 52, greater than 52, compare it with 86. Less than 86, compare with 65. Greater than 65, compare with 79. But less than 79, compare it with its left child. No left child is present, so that's why attach it as a left child. And the last node 85, compare it with 52, greater than 52, compare with 86, less than 86, compare it with 65, greater than 65, compare it with 79, greater than 79, so that's why attach as a right child of a root node 79. So in this way we can perform the insert operation onto the binary search tree. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. And here I am providing you a shortcut link for the subscription of my channel, and along with this I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.